Hi guys, it's a silver fox. And I've been asked several times now for me to do a video review on the kit that I'm carrying in my Maxpedition Sabercat. To be honest, I will go through the pack, but my kit is very similar to the old kit I carried in my old hip pack. But I'll go through it just so you can see. Okay guys. Well, firstly, if we go through, I've got my shoulder strap with a quick release buckle on the top to make it easier to take on and off. On the outside of this pack, what have I got? I've got a carabiner on this side, carries my knee pads and my leather gloves. On the other side, I have my camera case, which takes my stills camera and my video camera, and this old water canteen, which carries my 1 litre water bottle. In the bottom there, I also have a metal Crusader cup. On the front of this pack, here is my monopod. I normally have my tripod on there, but obviously the camera is mounted on the tripod now, so that fits on the front there. And because of the modifications I made, when I release the top strap, the monopod or my tripod or my knife doesn't come away. On the back of the pack is my large camp knife, which I'm able to withdraw whilst still wearing the pack and place it back in there. So that's on my back, reach behind, pull it out like the scout style, and put it back in scout style. That's why that mounts there. Also, on the back of my pack, where it's against my body, it's not in full view when I'm walking through public areas or woodland. In the back of this pack, I carry 2 very large, heavy-duty rubble sacks or bin bags. I use them for lots of reasons. I use them as emergency bivy bags. I use them for collecting leaf litter for making my bed. I use them for collecting wild edibles. You can use them to make emergency ponchos. There's 101 uses you can use for a heavy-duty bin bag. On the bottom of this pack, as before, on separate strip clips now, is my poncho and my rubber pad. I'm also working with my sleep system to incorporate that into this pack, and I've got 2 Exped dry bags which fit underneath here. One contains my hammock, one contains my tarp, and they also fit underneath this pack. So underneath. Right, working on the side pockets. And a small tin of deodorant. There is my first aid kit. I just keep it in a freezer bag just to help keep the moisture out. And then the bottom on this side, this is my toiletries. This small little pack contains everything I need. I've got wet wipes, I've got toilet paper, I've got a toothbrush, a razor. In this little tin, in the green side is my toothpaste, the yellow side is lip balm. So that's my toiletries. That's on that side. In the other side, which I normally have my hobo stove in this side, but I haven't put it in today because I'm not intending to be out for too long today. So in the side, I carry my spoon, wooden spoon. And all I've got in here is a billy can, a food can. So I'm out with a friend today. We're gonna collect some birch sap, which he's never done before. And this is a food bag that I always carry. So I've always got food with me. Right, now to the main parts of this pack. Okay, in the lid, my food for free book, always carry that in there. In the top here, again, all of this is easy access when I'm walking. So, got my head torch, a bottle of hand sanitizer, I have a second torch, a pencil with a rubber and gaffer tape on it, spare batteries for my torches. Both my torches incidentally take the same battery, that's a good tip. In the top I have my compass. I have a flexible tape measure. This is ideal for tracking, for marking signs and taking measurements. Covers inches and centimeters. I also carry two rulers in different colors, again, so you can get the contrast on the ground, depending what you're trying to photograph against. And I carry maps of the woodlands that I visit. These are off the Ordnance Survey map, the one to 25,000. And all I do is, rather than take the whole map with me, I cut out the section of map that covers the area that I'm interested in. And then I can fold it up. Say for example, I'm going to visit this wood, then I fold it up in the pack. The wood I'm going to visit or the area that I'm going to walk. So that's that. And these are the maps, incidentally, that I talk about in Block 1 on the UK Pathfinder system. These maps will actually give you the name of the farm, and that's how you can identify the area that, or the landowners for the land you want to try and gain permission for. Okay, in this main pouch, I try not to keep too much in here because this is the area that I want to change every time I come out. Depending on what I'm going to do, depends what I bring out with me. So today I've got a second knife with me. I've got a bandana, I've got a small plastic tub, which I'm going to use for collecting birch sap later. But I also carry extra things. I've got some hot chocolate in there. I've got some sugar, salt. There's some oil. It's like I keep it normally inside my hobo stove. So I keep the stuff in there. I've got a journal for making notes and for recording information that I find. In the back here, I have a very small flexible chopping board for when I do my cooking. That's a large foil barbecue tray that I keep in my pack, again for roasting food over a fire, but also for making a windbreak if I need to shield a fire or to shield my hobo stove. And then various sizes of Ziploc bags. A tobacco tin, which is my fire lighting kit. Various types of fire lighting material in there. An Altoids tin, which I use for making my char cloth in. My hat, my harmonica. And that's pretty much it that I keep in the front. As I said, this main area changes depending on what I'm doing. So I use the main area for carrying food, spare clothing, anything I wouldn't normally carry in my pack on an everyday basis goes in that main pouch. Okay, in the front here, these are where I keep my tools, in this front pouch. So, got my crook knife, folding saw. I've got my flint and steel that was made for me by Chris Grant. I keep that in there as another form of fire lighting. Fork, Niven, DC4, ceramic and diamond fire, sharpening stone. Carry that in there. This is a tool that I carry for flint napping to help put fresh edges on my bit of flint that I use when I'm using my fire steel. I also carry a small piece of leather and a rubber pad for napping as well. And in the back, I've got a mouse mat with three different grades of wet and dry paper glued to the front. So I've got a coarse, a medium and a fine. And I use those just for polishing my knife if I need to when I'm out in the field. So guys, that's what I pretty much carry in my Maxpedition Sabercat. What I've shown you is pretty much my core items that I always carry. I could reduce these items down to 10 items if I needed to, but that's my core items. And then I will add to my pack as and when, or depending on what I'm out to do. Okay guys, that's my contents of my Sabercat. What I've shown you is pretty much my core kit that I always carry. I can reduce these items down to make different size kits, like 10, 20 and 30 piece kits. But my basic kit is what you've seen on here for day hikes. The only thing I haven't got with me today is my blanket, the bedroll kit that I take. As I've said, I can put my tarp, my hammock can hang underneath this Sabercat. Then I just need to take a blanket roll to go on top. But that's my basic kit. I hope some of you found that of interest. It's very similar to my old hip kit. But as the people requested it, I felt obliged to do it for you. Okay guys, well that's my basic kit that I carry in my Sabercat. It's pretty much my core items, the items I always carry, is what I've just outlined to you. The only thing that's not included on this pack is my bedroll. My tarp and my hammock will fit underneath the pack like I showed you where my poncho is. And then I just need my wool blanket rolled up on top, which goes over a sling. And I'm sorted. So, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you soon.